So how the brain and the immune system communicate is clearly fundamental for human disease. One of the things we do really well here at NINDS and in the NIH Clinical Center is to develop new technologies that open windows into the biology of the brain and the immune system both. We were able to find in humans that there is a system of lymphatic vessels that works very much as had been observed in the mice. It's located within the dura mater, in the covering of the brain. It tracks along the major arteries and veins that are within the dura mater. The lymphatic system is a collection of vessels, like blood vessels, but they carry a special fluid called the lymph. This is one of the major ways that the body gets rid of the waste that is created, that is generated as sort of normal business in organs throughout the body. It's very important for teaching our immune system how to recognize what it should attack and what it should not attack. But there are some organs in the body, and in particular the brain, where those vessels don't exist or have not been thought to exist in the past. So it's been unclear how exactly the brain gets rid of the waste products that it generates. My colleagues in the lab study inflammation in the brain in diseases such as multiple sclerosis. And how the immune system interacts with the brain is extremely important in multiple sclerosis. And I thought perhaps this is an important aspect of how the immune system fails to work in MS, causing inflammation. The major way that we study MS is by imaging, using magnetic resonance imaging in particular, which is a great way of seeing the damage to the brain that is caused in MS. So here we started with the scientific question, do human beings have a lymphatic system? And based on our knowledge from the mouse work of where that might be, we looked specifically in those locations and then tuned the magnet so that we would be able to find them. So initially, we started taking these images and we saw vessels that looked very much like we expected they would if they were lymphatic vessels. But we couldn't really prove that they were lymphatic vessels without looking directly at the tissue under the microscope. The lymphatic vessels have their own lining of cells. They have certain specific proteins that mark them as being different from blood vessels. Anybody can adopt these techniques and do their own studies of the function of these vessels in various different patient populations, or even, for example, in normal healthy development. And hopefully, through that process, to understand what is the relevance in disease, whether this is something that's important for how disease develops or how we might be able to treat it.